Infowars.com. Yeah.
There is a multinational coup going on over this country. They've used corruption to do it. Total treason. You can just Google it. It comes up that she represents the Chinese. She represents anybody. She's like a street-walking whore. And it is so bold and insane that we've let this get to this point. So Dr. Steve Pieczenik at stevepieczenik.com put out a video yesterday breaking down the fact that Hillary and her cohorts have done a coup on America. Look at the FBI. I mean, she's above the law. And so that people in the military, the different intelligence agencies that we know have been giving WikiLeaks their info, the British ambassadors come out. William Binney has said on air and off air, I mean, he's gone further than we did 6 months ago. He says it is U.S. intelligence doing this. And they're ready for the government to try to come after them and others and ready to basically do press conferences saying, oh, okay, you know, here are the people that released it because this is treason. Go ahead and try to prosecute us. They were hoping that the FBI would do the right thing and would keep Hillary out. But they're ready, folks. So Hillary, one way or another, is in deep trouble. And Dr. Steve Pieczenik, again, one of the founders of Delta Force, head of psychological warfare in the State Department, ran, admittedly, this is in the BBC, you name it, has run the overthrow of at least six governments. He's the real deal in covert action. He's a psychiatrist, but also has a degree from MIT. Most of you know who he is, but he's never been seen in 25 years. Co-wrote books with Tom Clancy. He's the character Jack Ryan's based on. Hadn't been seen in 25 years. This is a guy that, you know, sends me photos when he's inside North Korea, you know, when he's on vacation. Wink, wink. I mean, he's the real deal. Everybody knows that. And you've seen the things he's talked about over the years come true. And so he's dialed in, folks, and we're dialed in as well. We've checked the things he said with high-level folks. And notice General Flynn is advising Trump. He's one of the leaders of the resistance. Okay? So all of this is happening. This is history happening. I'm going to try to shut up now and give him the floor until the end of the hour. Dr. Steve Pieczenik, please roll through what we're facing, the stages we're at right now, 5 days out from the election with their takeover group versus the ghost of George Washington, I'd call it, fighting for this country's life.
Well, Alex, why do I talk about both these issues? The ultimate distraction in this whole storyline with Huma Abedin and Anthony Weiner has been, to me, somewhat of a farce. It's been either contrived or combination of, you know, ongoing problems, but a highly contrived scenario. What I really want to talk about is the fact she's been here for a long time. And the question is, who gave her the top secret clearance that she had received after having been here only 2 years after 1996? So the question goes back to who, in fact, in our three-letter agency worked in Saudi Arabia. There's only one agency. It's either Catholics in Action or the CIA, John Brennan, who has been very close to the Saudi Arabians, and also the Israelis. Now, which distracts from the fact that Huma Abedin is very much of a Saudi agent. However, she married a Jew. A pathetic Jew, but nevertheless, that neutralized the notion that she was a total Saudi influence. At the same time, there's a man by the name who we're targeting named Peter Kadcik, K-A-D-C-I-C-K. That's news. He works with a law firm in Washington, D.C. called Dickstein Shapiro. I know Dickstein Shapiro. I know their senior partner, Barry Levin. They're not very good lawyers, qua lawyers, but they're extremely good at lobbying. 10, 15 years ago, they would charge me something like $600 per hour. So, you know, they're not the smartest lawyers, but they could be the most corrupt lawyers in the business. Peter Kadcik was brought into the Justice Department as a result of being Podesta's lawyer, and Peter Kadcik got Podesta off of criminal charges. Podesta, who's as stupid as the day is long, made a comment saying, this is my kind of lawyer. He makes sure that I never go to prison. So what we have is a Jewish law firm, Dickstein Shapiro, with a Jewish representative, Peter Kadcik, who is in turn going to evaluate and investigate a corruption trial with Huma Abedin. That's a complete farce. And the farce continues because the corruption that's going on between Hillary Clinton and Obama is so serious that when I said weeks ago that we had a civilian coup and that we in the intelligence community informally initiated a counter coup, that's a major, major statement. Now,
sure, when you talk about history, and I've confirmed with a lot of high-level folks, people are now ready to pretty much do anything to save the country because every other way and avenue to fix things has been basically shut down. So now let's get to the historical point we are, just for lay folks out there, Dr. Pieczenik, about why this has been activated, what you think is now going to unfold in the next 5 days, where we're going. I mean, explain to folks, talk to us like we're not, you know, former spy chiefs.
What's been activated is really an American revolution through the words of Donald Trump. He may or may not know the specifics, but that's not as important as the fact that he brought out the temperance and the anger that the American public feels, including what you said.
Well, sure, he's being advised by people that I know full well are part of the counter operation. So,
I mean, that's why I know Michael Flynn, I have the highest respect. I can't say anything more. He was the director of intelligence in the Defense Intelligence Agency. So there are those in the Defense Intelligence Agency with whom I have worked and still continue to work. So we're at a key point. What the intelligence community is saying is that there are several charges that want to be dealt with regard to Hillary Clinton. They want her to be indicted for bribery, corruption, obstruction of justice, lying under oath, and most importantly, it's a RICO charge. That's what we use against the Gambino family and the crime families. And the reason we want to initiate that, and there will be a prosecutor to come forth to prosecute her, whether she gets into the White House or not, is because she has been involved in massive corruption with massive collusion. Now, you're getting other people involved as well. So you're talking about Obama, you're talking about Loretta Lynch, you're talking about a Peter Katchik, you're talking about a whole line of people, including the Podesta brothers, who have been involved in this collusion of corruption.
Yeah, with Russia.
Where do we go from here? We have 5 to 6 days to go. If she is elected, there will be an initiative to impeach her as the president of the United States. Our suspicion is that Obama will not pardon her. The reason for that is Obama's too smart. He too came in through the intelligence system, as I've said before, particularly the CIA. He worked for Peter Geithner. He worked for the Asian Society. He is a front for many of these groups. Contrary to what he said, the story is total nonsense. He was not a initiator of civil action on the local level. He was very much a product of the CIA. But you've got to remember two things. Saudi Arabia's had a major influence in our government since the Clintons, the Bush seniors, the Bush juniors, and now Hillary. They wanted to make sure that they had somebody very close to the hand of power. And in this case, they initiated her and penetrated Huma Abedin very early on in 96. And I've got to say, as a counterintelligence agent, they did a very good job. Because no one in the press, not one person in the intelligence community, other than the people I've dealt with, have really spotted this. Secondly, there's an issue of diversity that people are concerned about, particularly Obama. Well, we have diversity because Israel has also penetrated our intelligence, as you've seen with Michael Chertoff and the other people involved in 9/11. So this is a continuation of the corruption and collusion that our government in Washington, D.C., as committed against the American people.
Sure. So let's boil it down then, Dr. Pieczenik. I mean, you put out powerful videos. You've gone public. You haven't been seen on video in two decades. Now, you got out of the Council on Foreign Relations 15 years ago and rebuked them for 9/11. You've been exposing it all. You've been dead on about the de-evolution back to the States, the Brexit. Catalonia predicted it here 5 years ago. And so this is a critical juncture right now. As you said, history is happening right now, a major moment in history, probably one of the most important in our history. What can the public do, to make sure this criminal is brought to justice?
Well, they can support Trump with the fact that he said this election is rigged. In other words, when the results come in, they can defy the results and stand up and say, we don't accept the results. And the reason for that is, again, you've talked about, and you had a very intelligent woman talk about, the fact that the D-ball machineries and Dominion have really rigged the machineries in such a way that if Hillary is viable, as that lovely lady said, she will win. If that's the case, then the American public have to stand up without violence and say we cannot accept this election result. There will be no way that Hillary can win legally.
That's right. They're already fractionally shaving. They're already flipping all over. They're already selling the narrative Trump's losing. Even in rigged polls, sampling 12% more, ABC and a bunch of others, he is now 6, 8, 9, 10 points ahead.
Well, there's no question that Trump will be in the forefront. There's no question that Trump will not accept the results of the election. I will also say neither will the intelligence community accept the results of the election. The most honorable thing that Hillary could do, and I doubt she will do it, is to resign. Probably the only person I can appeal to within that family whom I do know, and I think I regard it quite high, is Chelsea. I've known her since she was a teenager. She has had the same concerns about the Clinton Foundation that we've had. She's had major concerns about the corruption, about the fact that the foundation was taken over by the Podestas and Band or whoever the man was working with Bill Clinton. She's also the one who gave us the tip-off on the fact that 10,000 Haitians were killed because of the Clinton initiatives in Haiti, and she was dismissed. So I can appeal to her on the part of the United States to say to her, tell your mother to stand down. If she does not stand down, this will continue as a revolution. You don't need a psychiatrist to basically say what I've said all along. It's a woman who has come to the point of such self-destruction that she in turn will bring the whole country into a self-destructive mode. It's a woman who never really could achieve the aspirations that she stated. In other words, she claims she went to Yale, that's true, but unfortunately she's not as bright as she thought she was. She wasn't as accomplished as she maintained she is. Her judgment is terrible. Her ability to assess strategy and tactics is terrible.
By the way, her WikiLeaks, all her colleagues say she's a disaster and a horrible person. That's all the emails.
Well, I'm going to quote, and not only Podesta, but I'm going to quote General Colin Powell, who said, everything she touches, she messes up, and then he adds the word hubris with pride. So you have an arrogant, ineffectual,
loser,
dysfunctional woman who wants to be the president of the United States, has never really initiated anything on her own or accomplished any accomplishment of any significance.
She's a clear and present danger.
She's a total clear and present danger. However, in that sense, I do not want any attempts at assassination. I do not want an overthrow of a government. This is a natural evolution in the world of the internet and the binary numbers. What makes this so interesting is the fact that you, Matt Drudge, Limbo, Sean Hannity, Fox News, Brit Hume, and a whole bunch of others have really pushed the agenda that we've had and understood how to debride all of the nonsense that went on. I want to give special thanks to Lou Dobbs, who on the major networks really kept pushing on and saying, look, you Republicans are a failure. You Democrats are a failure. And I can't speak any more on behalf of what the intelligence community will or will not do, but you have seen so far how effective they have been and how they were able to turn around James Comey. And it was the brave men and women within the FBI, within the other agencies who stepped forward and said they will not accept this. This is the second American Revolution. I wrote about it in Maximum Vigilance. I wrote about a coup 20 years ago in Maximum Vigilance against the President of the United States. It was not only a hard coup, it was a soft coup in what we're talking about now.
StevePieczenik.com, we're having you on for an hour Friday. Thank you for all your time. And thanks
it's
for doing
my pleasure,
time.
And God bless your audience, will you? And thank you, Alex.
Amazing. Okay, wow. And again, speaking of the Internet Revolution, Joseph Farah, there goes Steve Pieczenik.
Listen to the radio host, Alex Jones.
It's required by Bill Clinton in 1992.
Over the last many, many years.
On November 8th, the arrogance of Washington, D.C. will come face to face with the righteous verdict of the American voter. It's about time.
The party of Lincoln has become the party of Trump.
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo. Americanism, not globalism. Americanism, not globalism. We'll be right back.